is a very, very interesting section. It's becoming very, very important. It's called the Tromb Wall. It was developed by a French engineer in end of the 60s. Was put in place by a French architect in 1970-something, and an American architect in Princeton used that, Kelbaud, for a house that he built in Princeton, that you can see the house still now, in 1974. Now, what is the Tromb Wall? The Tromb Wall is based on capturing the energy of the sun and accumulating that on a thick wall that in France was about 60 centimeters thick in concrete, and in the case of Kelbaud was 38 centimeters. The difference between the France project and the Kelbaud project is that in France it was one floor houses and Kelbaud was two floor houses. There were a lot of problems. Mainly because you absorb the energy during the day, but there is a dispersion during the night. So they solve later the problem, but anyway, other cases in an experiment of that period, you see that during the night they have kind of panel that they raise in order to keep insulated the house and not to have a dispersion during the night. So these are very, very interesting projects. What is interesting of these? And what is interesting, for example, of the biosphere there, number two, is that whenever you want to measure the efficiency of a system with some scientific parameters, you have to have an isolated system. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, you cannot measure anything. So in a certain way, even this experiment, but also all the experiments of that period, of the community of the solar houses in New Mexico and Arizona that have been built in between 1973 and 1975, they are in a certain way operating on the model of a total self-sufficiency of the system, separated from any other environment. And that is the only possible way that you can measure the efficiency of the mechanism. So the kind of biosphere is a kind of a metaphor of this kind of idea of self-sufficiency of a total closed system that, by the way, failed. But there are other projects in that period, for example, the New Alchemist, that they were another group there, that developed this idea of the arc, which is not so radical in terms of self-sufficiency, but was very, very similar to the idea of the biosphere, which means they produce their own food, they produce their own energy, they produce everything in a self-sufficient system with a community which was very small, maximum was about 20 people. So this idea of self-sufficiency and a closed system is very, very important for the buildings, but especially and also for also at the urban level. Now, perhaps it took a little bit too much here. We move quickly to